紧张刺激的揉揉的环节啊，揉的环节。你们说啊，你们说要揉几次，以最后一次为准，一次、两次还是三次？说吧。说完之后我写在上面。现在还没揉啊，现在是没揉。三次是吧？以最后一次为准是吧？都是三是吧？三次取最后一次啊！我们先来玩两次啊！我们先来玩两次，给你们看一眼啊！好，第一次啊，没子弹啊，写错了啊！哎，好久没那什么了，这是第一次啊。反正不管怎么揉啊，都是很劲爆的。好啊，第一次就那什么，第一次揉完了，然后第二次啊，再给你们揉一揉。好了 ，last time 吗？最后一次啊，最后一次。 好，肉完了啊。刺激啊，刺激！哎，那个手残 look 跟歌迷准备了，手残 look 跟歌迷啊。然后筛选条件我打出来了，筛选条件是这个。Nothing scheduled. 你们两个在不在？你们两个在不在？在的话来，来那什么，来，来歪歪。tag 没问题啊，2019年8月1日。先揉个游戏啊，先揉个游戏。I'm feeling lucky, 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 lucky.我是不是输错东西了？怎么才121个人上次？这个在那个，这个在游戏列表里面，这就不发了，重新揉一下。我是不是输错条件了？我昨天搜是400多个，为什么今天就一百？6.5 加50到80，然后的话，这个 scan tag need to list between 2019年8月。我是不是输错条件了？我再看一眼，我再看一眼。重新扔。打着 needle 的 tag include， 然后 list between 2019年8月1日到2019年7月3日，没错吧？那重新扔一下啊。I'm feeling lucky. I'm lucky. Little Maniac， 那应该没问题。Difficulty around 70， OK， 就他一场十五分钟，一场十五分钟。
Hi everyone, we're gonna have to actually like make sure the audio levels and such make sense and aren't awful. Hi Nell.
Hi.
哦，喂，我没开声音，开了，你说吧。
Great.
说吧。
Well, you can only be heard on the Fangame Marathon channel, not the Chinese, so there's like multiple commentary going on at the top.
That is true.
啊，第一轮是歌迷跟手残 Luke， 他们揉到那个游戏，谁下一下？我的网速突然爆炸。
You sound extremely loud. Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking. I need to turn it down. Well, it's on Cosmoing's end, so I need to log in.
Log in as Cosmoing, gotcha.
Yeah, basically.I sound gloomy. What the hell?
This is probably Cosmo's settings for us and how he's turned us up and down, so that's why I'm
quiet. Yeah, exactly. What are you doing, Cosmo?
I mean, I think it's appropriate for my levels. I can probably just talk louder. I'm good at that.
Okay, so me. Oh god, those are so loud, bro. Okay, I'm at 133%. I'm now at 100. You are at 81%.
Only 81? I figured it'd be like 20.
那边声音有点轻
啊。God, we're both loud though.
游戏下
了。Yeah, I can.
Yeah,
I can.
这样
可以。Otherwise, I hear us both doubled. Let me know if you want me to stop talking.
Well, I'm just like looking at the actual levels. And...
规则规则我打那个，我打
有实时画面吗？
我现在还没收留呢。
Lower,
规则是这样的啊，规则是八进四，四进二，二进一。然后呢，分组是刚才现场抽的，没有任何黑幕啊。就你给你们看了两随三次用最后一次那个结果。然后呢，每一轮，从 D F 上下这些游戏中的一个啊，揉到哪个是哪。
OK。
然后。
Yeah,
每一轮玩十五分钟，谁跑得快，谁赢。然后如果在同一个 save 里面，谁先到下一个 save，
right,
谁获胜。
So、drop
就是这个规则。然后你们游戏都有。
Ghost had the or Ghost Cosmo had the audio like pretty loud.
It's better than quiet, I guess. Better than too quiet. Easier to sum things down than up.
All right, now we're good. We're seeing high yellow.
Now high yellow. What's that mean?
Where it is in relation to the bar.
What bar?
In OBS.
There's a bar in OBS?
Yeah, now.
Look, I've not used the volume slider in OBS in a while. I actually don't know what... Oh yeah, it's because you use Studio, that's why I don't know it.
No, it's in Classic as well.
Is it? I don't know where that is. Where?
Yeah.
Do you mean on the main screen?
Yeah, you know where it has the volume mixer down below?
Okay, well, here's a screenshot of it. Tell me where the thing is.
Okay.
I don't see yellow on that, or green. There's only one color for that.
Yeah, so you see the mic and the speaker button?
Yeah, there's only one color under there, though. There's no yellow.
Oh, yeah. Is it just green?
Fairly certain it's just one color there.
Well, it, at the very least, if you reach the top, it turns red. I know that for a fact.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's always red.
Well, basically, yellow is like high yellow is the comfortable
range.
You know what else is comfortable? This stream and chatting with my good friend Wolfsk right now.
That is true. I will agree with this sentiment. put forth by
歌迷推流，歌迷先推个流，先把流给放进去。
Cool.
But like in relation to you.
Because talking to yourself, that'd be odd. That'd be weird.
I'm not talking about myself. That's weird.
No, that'd be strange. Nobody do that.
Now I'm quieter? Hell yeah.
I can just talk quieter. Is such a thing actually possible? I'm not sure.
Well, I turned myself down because it sounded like I was too loud. So let's go like somewhere in the middle. Because, like, I'm looking at the audio levels.
But how can you be in the middle when there's only two people?
And our audio levels seem to be going to, like, the exact same spot. So I don't know.
I don't know how I'm just naturally like, okay, well, you did it. Good job. Congratulations! 666666666. I don't know how you say that in Chinese.
Let's see. Let's go to translate. Six in Chinese, and it is Liu, right? Liu. Forgot.
Oh yeah, that makes sense. Yeah,
it's the thing that Bootstrap always said.
How long do you think this tournament's gonna last?
Well, it has an estimate, I believe, of 2 hours.
Oh, okay. These are some short games that are using dang.
Yeah, well, it's probably like a time limit thing more so than finishing the whole game.
Yeah. Yeah, because like looking at the bottom of the screen, it makes it sound like they're literally just going to random the needle games.
Mm-hmm.
And from what he did on Delfruit earlier.
In case you guys can't understand what's happening, this is a tournament with 8 players on the bottom. You can see all their names. We will be trying to refer to the people with Chinese names as what it translates to approximately.
Yeah, Walson's gonna try that. I'm gonna say the guy on the left or the right, because I'm not going to butcher the Chinese.
I think you only recognize Faz. Have you heard of Bummerman?
Yeah, he's a pretty well-known, experienced Chinese player.
Who am I voting for?
Shota, you
chin
a little. You press shift.
I agree, honestly. Oh. Oh.
Then, Gomi.
Jimmy
versus... No, there's two guys without translations.
Yeah, there's... Unfortunately. I mean, we can translate them, but Google Translate in Chinese is, has a couple of issues.
This no ball and ball, 随便。
Yeah, Q123 is the guy that destroys puzzle games. He beat Ponder and Gaze of the Horizon stupidly fast. Syra did a run of I Want to Hydrate earlier and was really good. And Jemmy is Jemmy, so...
If I were to personally choose a winner for the tournament, I would go 123 because he is a super good blind player. Like, he is one of the best blind players I've seen.
Oh, I think we're off. I do not recognize this game for the life of me, and probably neither does anybody else.
Yeah, I don't know what it was called. What was it called?
I don't know.
I think it was Needle Maniac.
I don't know who it's by. I have no idea about this game before, but I'm fairly certain nobody in this tournament's really knowing what's going on either.
They're just giving the game. Explaining what exactly is happening. So this is a tournament where they choose a game, have like a set region of where, like what the dates are, a set rating, set difficulty, and then they just hit random on Delfruit and then see what shows up. And then the two people that are selected randomly to go together will be going against each other and see who can, I'm assuming, get the furthest within the time period, because it's a 15-minute thing there.
Yeah, I really doubt they'll be able to clear all the games and they'll be rolling. Yeah, difficulty is between 50 to 80, at least a 6.5 rating. And then a couple of other things that were listed on the main page.
Yeah, August 2019 and presumably August 2020.
Yeah.
and the maker cannot be the person playing it.
Yeah, that does seem like it would be a bit biased if that was the case.
Yeah, Syrah's a very solid avoidance player. Syrah is very, very good at avoidance.
So yeah, this game in particular has an 8.3 on Delfruit, 69.5 difficulty is by Occult Cube.
With a very good title screen that I'm sure title screen reader would love.
Oh yeah, I don't think many games can really top that, honestly. Like, I've used Paint before, but I don't know if I could accomplish such a goal. Meanwhile, in the tournament, Jimmy seems to be really taking this away, already on the fourth save compared to Luke, who's still stuck on the first.
He is obliterating as he does, Mr. Jimmy. I wonder how many screens this game has, because this could just be like a one-screen game.
It doesn't feel like it. I feel like this is going to last at least a few.
Yeah, it's definitely more than one screen. That's good to know.
Thanks for your input, Wallsclad, for that.
You're welcome. Because, man, if they rolled a one-screen game...
That would have been quite the ride. Yeah, so how long does this race last? I don't know, between 1 and 3 minutes?
Yeah, there is a small chance they've played the game before. And if there is a player like Zero, for example, who just plays every Needle game, or Tuka, then it would be pretty likely that they would have already played it. But I don't know how much all of these players do, like, new releases and just in general, playing a bunch.
Jimmy, I wouldn't be surprised if he's played everything, but I also wouldn't be surprised if he's played nothing and he's just going to destroy us all.
Yep, exactly.
Like, I still remember Jimmy was one of the main guys I was pointing out to people from Fangame Marathon 2019, I believe, for a CN2 run. And because people had no idea who he was in the West at that point. I was just saying, like, if there's one run you've got to watch, pay attention to Crimson Needle 2, because Jimmy just destroys Needle, as he is showing in this race at the moment.
On the first screen, which save do you think is the hardest?
I'm gonna have to go with the first one because Luke's still on that right now.
I would say the fourth save looks the hardest to me.
I'm not good enough at Needle to honestly tell fast enough.
Sick. Fourth save seems rough because of the landing after the little set of
yeah,
and also the final jump.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think there's still a clip of that or a highlight of that somewhere, Bola. Jimmy's an enigma? How exactly? He's been around for ages.
I'm pretty sure they just mean enigma in like the sense that he is unimaginably good. Wow. That drop was smooth.
Jeez, okay. And, yeah. Oh, he's not two-frame that every time. Interesting. Yeah, I don't know. Considering how many ultra-good players there are, this honestly doesn't surprise me.
Yeah, you will see that in this race, Jimmy is definitely not the only good one. As good as Jimmy is, don't underestimate the rest of the players.
Yeah. Because, like, we've got players like Faz, Syrah, Q123, and some Western asshole. I don't know. He's in there too.
Yeah. You're right.
Don't really know how he managed to just slide his way in there, but there we go. There's a Western guy in there too.
He must have just, like, done some pretty heavily illegal stuff.
Yeah, probably bribed him or something.
Blackmailing.
One thing I can say for sure, that guy is probably never playing Classic now.
Yes, Slur is a very good player. But he excels at avoidance for sure.
Man, yeah, Luke is having a really rough time on this first save.
加一下。
Oh dang, I just noticed the timer has like water in it. Is that
Yeah, no, it's doing that for all of them. Yeah. It does that for all the runs. They're all maxing out. It's so cool. Like, they've got some production value in this marathon that FM may need to steal from for once.
Oh, he's adding the game name. Yay.
Oh,
thanks, Ghost.
Cool. Oh, I was just fully prepared to say it every single time.
For people who are not aware, in our initial announcement for this FASF marathon, I mentioned that they have a much smaller tech crew. What I really meant by that was Ghost does 95% of the work, and then the other 5% was
also Ghost.
No. The other 5% was this one worked on the.
Oh, you mean Bickle, the guy that worked on the online thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, Bickle did some of the website stuff.
Yeah. And he did a good job with the website.
Yeah, he also helped out with the waiting screen, the intermission screen between things, because it's connected to the chat for Bilibili.
Ooh.
So, yeah, Ghost showed that off, that I think it's when somebody sends a message, a spike appears on the screen, and then the kid will jump over it.
Only a few people want to race. Yeah, I can see it. And then I saw the players and was like,
Yeah, that's like pitting myself up against Nader or something. Like, I'll do it, but I'm not gonna do well.
Oh, Jemmy didn't move a frame over before doing that squish thing.
Jeez, yeah, this save looks really hard too.
It is quite a few diagonals and squish diagonals, and that is the whole save.
Yeah, this is definitely not an easy save.
Yeah, you'd have to be a needle maniac to beat this one.
I get it.
Thank you.
Yeah, I do feel a bit bad for some of the other participants. Like, imagine being the guy that has to go up against these people. It doesn't matter how good you look, you're going to look bad in comparison. Like, Luke might be a really good player, but because of nerves and because he's having to compare against Jemmy, he looks significantly worse.
Well, he beat the first save, so I'm feeling the comeback, personally.
Yeah, sure, this might be his chance, finally.
Jemmy is stuck on the save, so this is Luke's chance to just do 3 screens in 5 minutes.
It seems like a reasonable amount of time.
If anyone can do it, it's Luke. I know that because I am very familiar with him as a player.
Yep, I know the name Luke as well. I have heard it many times in my life.
Yeah.
Had friends named Luke.
That one guy in that film's named Luke, yeah? He's generally pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Although I think he might be... No, I don't know. No, I didn't see that film, so I'm not sure, actually.
Well, growing up, my parents always told me to Luke both ways.
They're trying to prepare you for Needle, I see, yeah. Yeah, they're trying to prepare you well. You've got to look both ways before you cross the Needle Street. Don't want to run into any spikes as you're crossing the road there.
Oh, we're not bullying Luke. We're just not very familiar with him as a player, so we can't say much.
Yeah, we really don't know anything about him, unfortunately. I'm sure Luke is a great guy, and we get on well with each other. But unfortunately, we don't know anything for sure, so...
Yeah, and there are a few players in this tournament that we don't know.
Yeah, I'm definitely not going to blame him for playing a game like this, like, slowly, because I don't think I'd be doing any better for sure. As shown from how last year's blind race went.
Yeah, you were really happy about that one.
I've had better times. He can, but yeah, no, it's very hard, yeah, for sure. Like, I certainly don't blame him.
I mean, at the very least, making the decision, wow, Jimmy, making the decision to even join this with the other players who are in this, regardless of your skill level, is bold.
Yeah.
Wow, Jimmy.
Okay, you're clearly ahead of me somehow.
Oh, well, I'm sorry.
Yeah, stop ruining it.
You could refresh the stream with the refresh the stream button.
I'm watching on Fangame Marathon so I can see both chats.
Oh. Yeah, remember when I said you should do it off Bilibili so that way it's...
No, I never heard you say that.
Yeah, I said that. I said you should do it off Bilibili so we're not having all of our commentary delayed.
Right. Too late.
Nice, dude.
Well, for me, it's Fangame Marathon's actually ahead right now because I haven't refreshed Bilibili in a while. No, they're actually on the same moment. They're at the exact same point. So yeah, we are actually watching the same thing. You were just like a second ahead of me.
Wow. The Fangame Marathon stream is ahead of the Bilibili one for me.
Yeah, exactly. For like a split second. There were some technical difficulties at the end of Bummer's run, I assume that affected it somehow.
Gotcha.
Yeah, the less time on the clock, the closer and closer it gets to red. Ooh. It's really cool. I also first saw the clock on the I Wanna Hydrate run, so that also felt very appropriate, and I wasn't sure if it was a one-off.
I gotta say, this game looks more like more, or it looks like more than a 70 to me. Maybe not.
You could play it next stream and find out.
I could. That is something I could do. It does look kind of fun for some saves and then less fun for others.
And one last stream for Jemmy before time's up, I guess.
I think you could do two.
I don't know. 40 seconds is not much time, even for Jemmy. Yeah, no, I noticed this winter, don't worry. Delphi ratings are always a difficult thing to go by, but I'd say it works well for something like this.
Ask them how they did this. Well, I mean, Ghost is on the Fangame Marathon tech crew, in the same way that we are on the FAST tech crew. So, we very much have contact with each other.
Luke, 辛苦了。
What I want is a website, because man.
Yeah, that's a good website.
Hey.
Oh, GG, there goes time.
Well, I think Jemmy took the first round.
Maybe it's a best of three. Maybe Luke can bring it back.
That would be a very long tournament.
Yes, it would. I'm assuming the next round is going to be Syra versus Q123, which just sounds absolutely terrifying. Bomber, you're in this tournament. You vote for yourself. That's how it works. And then when you lose, you vote for the one that beat you, because they're clearly going to be the victor now. Between Syra and Q123? Still Jemmy.
Oh, rolling time.
Yep. It's 121 games to choose from, apparently. Hestia, this is a Zeus-like, isn't it?
It's a Hades-like.
Hades-like, yes. That's what I meant.
我操，不要吧！我
的 This is gonna be interesting. Okay. This is very upper end of the difficulty scale too. So, like, this is a very close to being the 80 mark.
Oh, this is Siren MQ123. Okay.
Yeah, Siren MQ123. That's what I was saying.
That's
This is gonna be a terrifying match to watch.
这游戏应该是重新揉的，你们说呢？规则上是这么写的。
And if you want to truly experience just how good these players are, feel free to play along with them.
可以，就他了。
Yeah, you have the chance to download the game before they do, so feel free to give the first few saves a shot and realize that, yes, the game is in fact difficult and they're just making it look easy. So yeah, to give some points of reference to this, Q123 has been known for beating both Honda and Gaze the Horizon, I believe, in times that seemed a little fast compared to most. Syrah, I don't know too much about, but he did a I Want to Hydrate run, which is a very recent game. And he beat it in a bit under an hour, I believe?And did not look like an easy game to me. And he's also done runs of Call Me It in very, very fast times as well. I believe it's 22 or 23 minutes.
I believe Syra was the winner of the blind avoidance tournament last year. So.
Yeah, someone mentioned that as well. But that's avoidance. And as we all know, avoidance and needle skill are completely separate.
That's true. You can't be good at both.
Yeah, if you're good at dodging fruit, that doesn't mean you're good at dodging spikes. He came second place in last year's Blind Needle Race. Well, as we all know, that's a race, not a tournament, so completely irrelevant as well. It's just a one-time thing. Here he's got to be good in multiple-time things.
Thanks, Nell.
No problem.
Man, I love this random spike thing.
Yeah, it's... No, that's the thing. It's not random. It's whenever somebody does a specific cheer in the Billy Billy chat, a spike appears.
Man, are they really cheering that often?
There's a lot of ones going on at the moment, yes. I don't know exactly how it works. I tried asking Ghost about it, but I'm fairly certain you get some for free for watching. So, yeah.
而且我敢说基本上有人会把所有游戏都玩过一遍的，对吧？所以
But yeah, there's a lot of ones coming out right now, specifically for one name in particular, from what I can see. And one guy in particular is just spamming the ones in the chat. Yeah, they're like channel points. I don't know exactly, because I'm fairly certain you can pay for them as well. So I don't know exactly how it works, if they give something to the streamer too. So, yeah, okay, that sounds right, yeah. So, you go for watching Gold you pay for. Oh, you actually paid for some. Oh, interesting. I have no idea if I have any. Oh, okay, that's cool, Bummer. Alright.So can you explain to me how you get silver then in Billy Billy? Because I never understood. Because I have no idea where the number is that says how much of that I might... No, I don't think I have any. I just have none for some reason. I don't know, I've watched FASF before. Oh, okay.
I don't know where to look to find out if I have any.
That's fine, you don't have any.
Wow.
You just made your account.
No, I didn't.
You didn't? No.
No, I've had this account for years.
Well, I assume it's like right at the bottom, middle of the screen. There's like a gold and silver looking symbol. I got zeros next to both, so.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah, I have no idea how you get them then. Fair enough. You solve a math problem. Oh, okay, interesting. That's what I've been doing wrong. Haven't been doing enough math.
Users can obtain gold seeds through B currency exchange or recharge. The props exchange for golden melon seeds can make the anchor earn income. Okay, so those are bits.
Yeah. Melon seeds, I actually do remember hearing that phrase from Ghost as well.
Silver melon seeds. Users can obtain silver melon seeds through coin or golden melon seeds exchange. The items exchanged by the silver melon seeds can make the anchor gain popularity and improve the ranking. So it affects your rank on the site.
Yeah, I think so. The streamer's rank, I guess. Actually, no, yeah, it is the user's site rank, yeah. I really like this impossible mode warp here.
That's gross.
That's really good. I mean, if you're going to try to beat a Hades game on impossible, this is probably the basic minimum requirement for that.
Well, so the biggest problem with it is I think it might actually be impossible unless you're really paying attention to your line for some of them.
Oh, maybe. Okay, well, we've got an immediate difference between Q123 and Syrah. What? One of these players... Oh, no, never mind. Q123 is set up as well now.
Huh?
Q123 was just going for it without a setup at first. We're immediately seeing how hard this is. Yeah. Immediately seeing how hard this is, with the first jump being a problem.
Oh, they both finished at the same time. Oh, yeah. My god. But Syrah already first trying the second save.
Easy saves, only got one diagonal on the corner, basically. It's not even a problem. This one's really tough looking, though. This is very high jump you gotta do.
And let's see if... Did either of them realign? Okay, cool.
Yeah, one just did.
Syrah finally realigned. Because they probably did not have a good one for the ledge or for the first jump.
And Q123 doing the same. I don't know what that face of the pops up from Sire is every so often when he restarts. Is that an actual ledge? I think it's nerfed a little. No, I just can't see on Fire's side.
Yeah, no, that's a real one. Yeah, that girl that's popping up is someone that I recognize.
So you want to say same? Same. Dang, even after you get on this ledge, it still is definitely not an easy jump, though.
Honestly, both of the jumps look hard. I don't even know which one I would consider harder.
Yeah, they're very, very difficult. I think the second one's more of a problem because it is the further in one. Like, the first one just doesn't seem too bad, I want to say. Because it seems like it is the good line for the ledge, as most just trying to get high enough with the F jump part. Whereas the second one, you've got to be very careful with making sure you don't touch the top spike on the way down. Because, yeah. Syrah's gotten through the first jump quite a few times, but he just keeps dying at the top spike on the second part. Whereas Q123 have not been able to see how many times he's made it through yet. They keep getting really close, just not quite making it. I can't tell if they're jumping too high from when they start. Where they start the double jump from, I mean. Right, it definitely doesn't get any easier from here with the rest of the saves either.
Next save definitely looks easier.
Looks alright.
As does the one after that.
Okay, fine, so the rest of the game is easy. Gotcha, thank you, boss.
And then the one after that looks hard. Yeah. Really hard. It's got a fine mix of. Although that being said, man, that second save was kind of out of nowhere.
Yeah, that second save doesn't seem too bad compared to some of the rest of this, that's for sure. This save feels like it's going to be a real deal breaker, though. And the first save was a bit of a problem, but that was mostly just figuring out your double jump, whereas here, it's like both jumps are difficult for sure.
Ah, Syrah is opting to realign on the ledge.
Oh, interesting.
To hopefully get past the spike in front of the save point. Oh, He would have made that if he had actually saved in the air. He could have done that.
Oh, that's true.
Ooh. Again.
I don't know if that's a good solution, but it's certainly working out for him.
Well, the ledge that you have should in or the line that you have at the start should be fine in theory. But
yeah, but we're dealing with ultra precise jumps here, so you can never quite be sure. Yeah. Ooh, Q123's got the same idea now. I don't know if they can hear each other, so maybe they're hearing each other's ideas and working together in a sense. Yeah, it's S save, so you gotta press S when you're touching the save.
Yeah, you can't shoot them. Man, oh man, this is not going well for the two runners.
Hey.
This is kind of what you expect though when you completely do random games.
Yeah, there's always a chance of this happening. Occasionally, even if it's a high-rated game, there's always a chance that you just get something that's kind of out of the blue compared to everything else.
I want to look up a video and see what exactly they're doing wrong.
Well, you've only got 10 minutes, so you better be fast about it. I have absolutely no idea what happened in the case of a tie. I'm going to assume it's whoever got to the safe first, but I'm honestly not sure.
Okay, first video I see is someone saving in the air.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
Oh, second video I actually saw someone make it, though.
Oh, interesting. It's possible.
Yeah, it does look very gross, though.
I'm sure.
And they're not realigning, so it's just a matter of do the right inputs.
Yeah, okay, so it's whoever got to the save first. So I guess in this case it's Syra. Oh, Syra.
There it is.
He found the strat. Is this a 4.5?
Yeah, apparently. I didn't realize that at first. That's
I thought that looked
pretty
simple. I thought that looked a bit higher than 4, but I couldn't quite tell.
Oh, 两边都一样啊.
What?
两边都一样啊.
Oh, dude, Q123 just made it.
Oh.
Didn't even need a save jump.
So now they're back on the same save together.
Yeah, but Cyrus is still the first to make it, so he's still currently in the lead. Oh, whoever beats the save.
Whoever gets the next save first.
Oh, my mistake. Well, Cyrus is doing pretty well at this stage, just having some trouble with the second jump. Whereas Q123 is getting very stuck at trying to do the bunny hop for the 4.5 here at the start.
Yeah. Ooh, that was close though.
I'm not sure the save is as easy as you thought, Walt.
I mean, maybe not. Like I said,
a double jump seems to be a bit of a problem. Yeah. Oh, there you go then. Sorry about
that.
Yeah, awesome. In about 30 seconds, Q123 will be joining him, because that's how this has gone so far.
Syra just trying to find a spot where he can stand. There we go.
Yeah, the second jump is pretty clear cut, but it's definitely not easy. Now back to another hard save for Syra, apparently.
Yep, this one looks pretty brutal. This first jump in particular.
And here we learn that Walt may or may not be wrong. Ah!
Well, I'm committing to what I said.
Yeah, Q123 is still just having a bit of trouble with this save at the moment as well. definitely isn't making the 4.5 quite as frequently as Syrah was, which is a problem because obviously the more times you do that 4.5, the more chances you get the second jump. And that second jump is quite challenging in itself.
首先 Q 一二三不擅长单机，其次赛姐玩过这个游戏，虽然挺久远了，半年了是吧？但是至少肌肉记忆还在的 ，muscle memory 还是有。你看，这不又飞了一个档，现在领先三个。
GG，
alright，
I guess we'll score one after all. Save it easy.
I'm still committing.
I'm afraid I'm not sure if we're going to get some more proof right now, but maybe Q123 will prove me wrong.
Cyrus still hanging on to that. Oh no, Q123 resetting on successfully getting it.
Ah, that's always upsetting. Making it to the save and resetting is always a bad time.
This is actually on the level of roll 到单次不能避免，但我已经尽力降难度了。这个选的是50-80的。你如果 roll 到个
yeah, you can very clearly see that this game is an 80 difficulty thing, though, considering these two players are exceptionally good. It's 10 minutes and we're still on the first screen.
Generally, Hades likes games are like maximum 4 or 5 screens. So.
Are they? I thought they were always 3.
The original Hades was. 4, I'm pretty sure. So.
Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah, I always forget one. My bad. No? Yeah, I thought OG Hades was 3 screens, but maybe I'm wrong.
Could be. So, Syrah, they're on the second screen now. Q123 finally getting past the FPS thing.
He's got a chance!
操，这还要出超小啊。
Oh, she's from, she's from Love is War. Name is, Is she Kaguya-sama? I guess she's Kaguya. Yeah, there we go. That's who's appearing.
Gotcha. I didn't know her at all then.
Cool. I had to figure that out, because I knew I recognized it from somewhere.
Yeah, Q1 is going to have to work fast. There's definitely not too much time left.
That being said, the save that Cyrus on looks pretty rough, so... I don't know if Q123 has the ability to catch up in only 2.5 minutes, but...
Yeah, the remaining saves are definitely quite challenging in their own right.
Is
it finished? It's almost finished. It's almost 2 minutes. I'm telling you, Sai Ye and you both hit the third turn, hit 1,000 years, and you both hit the third turn.
Yeah, it looks like Q123 is just using a worse strat for the first jump than Syrah by attempting to one frame it.
Yeah, adding in an extra jump is never a good idea for something like this, that's for sure.
So he is accidentally making it a lot harder for himself in comparison.
What's the offer?
真是掏空的。
Okay, I just checked. This game does have 4 screens. And Hades does as well.Hell yeah.
可以可以。
30 seconds left. Syra is actually past that save that I was worried about. And Q123 on the other save I was worried about. Oh, is the Kaguya just the game over screen? That makes
sense. Yeah, I think it might be just part of the game. GG.
GG. Syra obliterating.
Q123 definitely put up a good fight, but unfortunately, Syra definitely pulled away with it there.
Which means my original prediction is immediately out.
Yeah, and once he got past the 4.5 save, it was unfortunately just kept gaining his lead there. Harder and harder to catch up after that. Yeah, the question is, can Sara beat Jemmy? And the answer is possibly.
I would say there's definitely a solid chance.
So,
we have...
I was just going to ask the thing you were already saying, so feel free to carry on.
Cool. Thank you. So this is going to be Black versus Faz. Faz, a player who more people will know in our community. Black, I don't personally know, but Faz is a very good speedrunner and player in general. He's done things on Fangame Marathon before, like...
Camellia 3 and Camellia 3.
Yeah, true. And on the fast marathon, he did Quo 300.
Yeah, easy mode specifically.
Yep. So he is a very good player. I guess we will find out how Black is as a player because we don't actually really know him. So.
Just give me an hour 40. I could probably win.
True.
I'll give Koala about half an hour. That's also good.
I'm gonna copy that name and put it onto Delphine and see if he's made anything.
Yeah, nobody knows the games are gonna be played until literally the moment it's rolled by Ghost on stream. So that's what we're seeing right now.
Well, I found his Billy Gilly page.
Nice.
Some needle experiments. Oh, that's a fun
interesting.
One.
So this is on the lower end of difficulty. Actually, that might be too low. Did they say 65 plus? No, 6.5 plus, that was it.
Yeah.
63 to difficulty. Yeah, this is definitely on the lower end compared to the previous game, which is on the harder end. The game that we just saw was like right on the cusp of being too hard for this. And this one's right on the cusp of being too easy. So both players will probably just be blasting through the saves. Which means that like any minor mistake you make for death is probably going to make a big difference.
Just looking at the different highlights and such that Mr. Black has on his Bilibili page, he seems probably like average skill. He has a video of Yurkara Needle, but it only goes to floor 69 from a few months ago. Did Witch's Tower. But, nothing super of note. Oh, he did a simple needle, apparently. Unless that's someone else's video. Because it could be.
Oh, it's 50-80, my bad. I remember it wrong, I thought it was 60-80. No, I'd say 50's alright. It's a different kind of, like, race in that sense. Because in that sense, it's trying to... 430 results, dang. Yeah, when you get an easier game that's being raced, it's more about trying your best to do everything as deathless as possible, compared to harder games, which is trying your best to just get through as many saves as possible. Both are interesting races in their own right, they just play out in a very different way. It's only 121 now. Yeah, I don't know.
That just means that 400 or 300 Fangames were just deleted in the past day.
Yeah, the mods were going really ham on some of those recently.
The mods really just do everything
they really
they can
don't like
to take down the site.
Yep. Ruining everything yet again.
Yeah, I was just looking at the VOD to check to make sure all the things that were input by Ghost were correct, and yeah, they're all right. So, who knows if maybe yesterday it was just something different. Because today it is definitely correct, I can confirm that much.
Wow.
Yeah, there's some strange noise going on. We can hear it too. I'm not sure what it's from.
Must be aliens.
I wonder if they're... Somebody's clearly playing something, but yeah, I'm not sure what it's from.
I still think it's aliens.
It could be. Oh, there we go. So, Wolf, you seem to know this game. What's it like?
What game is this?
Sony League Experiment 3.
Oh, I don't know a ton about the game. I just know that basically it was... They're games with very weird spikes, from what I understand, like Silly Needle Expo.
Okay.
I could be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure that's what the game is. Faz already cleared it. Okay, well then they're not doing that one. So it has to be games that they haven't played.
Makes sense. Oh, I guess they reset the settings on the tournament too by accident. Well, I guess Luke has his second shot after all.
You can do it, Luke. Just do it as your avatar says.
扣个一，好了，扣个一。
You sure they're playing a different game, Bubba?
This is looking very much like, oh, maybe they're not even playing a different game. Maybe he's just saying that he cleared it, but it isn't affecting anything.
It definitely looks like it at the moment. We have Faz, and on the left we have the other guy.
Black.
Yes, that is what you say the name translates to.
It is. I mean, you can also say Heifei.
I'm not going to say Chinese. I don't trust myself with that.
Awesome.
So yeah, this game is around 60 difficulty, apparently. So the aim... For this, I assume it's going to be more about not dying than trying to beat as many saves as possible. Because both players will probably beat an awful lot of saves. I say, as I notice, there's These are some very long saves, hey?
Yeah.
I was starting to wonder if there was even a second save for a moment. I thought it was just one long screen.
Very visually pleasing.
Yeah, for sure. Reminds you of White Shadow Stage in No Name Spike 2.
It reminds me of New York City at night.
Have you ever been to visit New York City at night?
I was born in New York City.
Oh, well, then you probably have a pretty reasonable idea. From those zero-year-old memories.
That's true. Because right when I hit the age of one, I was already gone. That's a joke. Yeah, I'm a big fan of black backgrounds.
You want me to laugh for you?
You don't have to. It's implied.
Okay, good. Yeah, this is definitely a lot longer than I was expecting after seeing the 60 difficulty, but I guess I shouldn't be too surprised. So maybe it will be more about how many saves everyone can beat still. Because it seems like despite having beaten this game before, FASF is still having some trouble with it.
FASF is just nervous.
Honestly possible. Maybe this other guy is just really good and we just don't know enough about him yet.
And both players are doing about equally as well on this save, but it did look like Black has gotten further through it.
Yeah, he's gotten to... I have no idea how to name any of these jumps, so... Like the middle of the screen a couple more times than FASF has so far.
Sounds like Walsk is commentating. Yeah, it would sound like that.
Yeah.
I do sound pretty like Walsk.
Yeah. So here in the call we have Walsk and Wolfie.
Yeah.
I'm Wolfie.
Yep. I'm Walsk. Nice to meet you. I was going to say that to myself and then you beat me to it.
Well, clearly this game is harder than the previous one, judging by the speed at which saves are being progressed.
I'm
gonna check GoPro quickly for this one. So this game actually has 5 ratings apparently. Oh, okay, 4 ratings and 1 from the maker. And they all say this game's around 60 or 65 difficulty. I guess it's just because of the length of the save is causing quite a bit of trouble for them both.
Maybe this game is just 2 screens long.
I mean, all the things we've seen so far have been relatively short saves. This is the first game that we've seen that's got a save longer than 3 jumps.
The outline does not kill, that's all visual. Right, this time, I'm feeling it for... Okay, never mind. I was like, this time FASF has got it.
Yeah, FASF really seems to be struggling with the... air quote, 3-spike jump there in the top middle. Seems to be causing him a lot of trouble, whereas... Black seems to be struggling a little bit with the jump right after that. We have to single jump into the gap on the spike.
Both of them showing that this is, in fact, impossible.
Not sure what these reviewers are thinking. Delfruit reviews aren't always the most accurate at times. So it could turn out this game is...
popular belief.
Yeah, they are not always perfect. So it could turn out this game is just 90 difficulty and we just weren't aware yet. Oh, bit too early on the double jump from FASF there, that's a shame.
Oh,
Black's trying to realign for this, I see.
He's going for the aligned strats. Ah, neither of them.
Second death to that spike.
Can't hit it on the right frame. And after that, it's pretty easy, so. It's rough.
Nice.
Alright, FASF. Okay.
He has a chance.
Okay.
Oh, he can do full jump it.
This
last jump's hard.
So on the left screen,
it looked like a gap, the same. Okay. The exact same thing.
Cool, because I was like, that looks really easy for a final jump, and then, you know, suddenly you look over at the other screen and it looks impossible.
Okay, yeah, you just got a 1 in 100 chance, but there's just no block there.
Yeah. Oh.
Poor Black, that is upsetting.
Yeah, dude, that was spamming a little bit on the reset key. Clearly not too thrilled.
Oh, that last jump definitely looks actually quite difficult too. The save after is perfect fine, as shown by Faz beating it really quickly, but like, this first save is a really hard one for sure.
I'm
That one really got you, huh?
Yeah, I'm really proud of that.
Well, Faz has got his opportunity to pull ahead here as well, because Black is definitely struggling a little bit more with the first save. Clearly not quite as easy as we first thought, because we couldn't see one of the blocks on screen.
This game in general looks pretty rough.
Yeah, for sure. You got to weave all the way down on this thing.
Nice.
Ooh, buddy, next it through.
Faz finally getting his stride.
I think it's more just every save isn't quite so hard after the first one, which is nice.
Yeah, that as well.
Third save definitely seems like it's a bit of a problem again, aka the first save on the screen that Faz is on, but second save doesn't seem too bad again because it's relatively short.
First jump looks like a doozy though.
It's first jump, so that's never too bad. Oof. Meanwhile, Black's still trying his best. Gonna say he had another opportunity, but unfortunately, the three spike jump there does seem to be causing quite a bit of trouble. Mr. Because of the sprites, it might be a little hard to tell when you can double jump, so some people may be tempted to jump a bit too early. Because the very border of these spikes does not in fact kill you, despite how it looks.
Yeah, it's like Orion, but less distracting.
Runa does love his visual effects.
Yeah, he does. Man, some of these blocks are just so dark, it just really doesn't look like they exist.
Yeah, that's just from when...
There it is!
Oh, he's done it! Okay, well, Black has 6 minutes to catch up. Admittedly, it's only 2 or 3 saves, so he does actually have a fair reasonable chance here.
Although
the same as his problem doesn't seem to be too much of a problem. Oh!
I was gonna say it's I'm pretty sure it's like 3 whole screens. Yeah.
I thought that Faz was on screen 3 currently. Which means there's like 2 saves on the next screen for Black and then the save he's currently on.
Maybe.
Maybe I'm forgetting one already, that's entirely possible. Either way, he has a shot now.
What's it?
As on screen 4, I may have just completely forgotten the screen, good.
Yeah, he did tear through screen 2, so... It did not last very long.
Yeah. Jeez, I genuinely already don't remember that one.
It's okay, hopefully you'll be able to see it when Black reaches it.
Hopefully not for long, though.
Oh, last jump of the save looks really rough.
Yeah. Hey, it's not an easy one for Faz there. This song really fits the neon aesthetic.
There we go. That is a super rough final jump. game looks fun.
So, Osk, in your expert needle opinion, what do you have to say about this game and its intricate needle design?
I think it looks like a 32-pixel needle with longer saves.
Cool, thank you, Osk.
There's really not a lot... Okay, well, as I said, 32-pixel needle, there's some stuff that's off-grid, but, I don't know, there's not a lot to say about the design. In terms of like the actual needle design, it just looks like it flows pretty well for a lot of the jumps, minus the first save.
Yeah, the first save will be a bit of a problem for everybody.
Yeah, I remember the screen. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Faz on screen 4 right now.
Just listen to me and Q123.
Either way, Faz is definitely putting ahead a bit more still. He's been doing very well on the saves he's currently on.
And Black took a while on that second save that Faz destroyed.
Yeah, Faz beat that one very fast as well.
Ooh, that's a rough jump on Faz.
Far to the side for that jump, that's for sure. Meanwhile, Black is on one of the saves that Faz did get stuck on for a while, so he can try to save a bit more time if he does this quickly. But he does only have a bit over 2 minutes left to try to catch up. It's going to be a hard challenge.
And he definitely seems to be struggling with it.
Yeah, it does seem to be a hard to save. So what do you say for the jump after one Faz is currently stuck on walls? Would you go over or under for that?
I would say going... Honestly, either one will work. I would probably opt for under.
I think I'd opt for over, personally.
I think both options are good.
Okay, cool.
It's probably easier to go over, honestly. But...
I don't feel like I'd be able to personally line up going under on that one. I'd be trying to jump too low with a single jump. If I was going over, I can just treat it kind of like a three-spike jump and just full jump for the double jump.
Yeah, my fear is just pressing right too early and then hitting into the spike. We'll see what Faz opts to do, if he makes it there.
Yeah, the jump before does seem to be causing quite a lot of trouble. Oh, and he's going for the over option because it looks free. But that could just be because Faz was doing it and he makes it look easy.
Faz is a good player. Yeah, this is a good remix. Sounds like something that would be in a Sun Lao Cube stage.
Well, there goes time. So this round goes to Faz. Unfortunately, that first save on the first screen was causing a bit too much trouble for Black.
As of right now, we've seen two matches that were not very close, and then we had one that was very close. We'll see if things will tighten up as we work up the ladder.
现在组织就不好奶呀。
Why ever would you be tired, Baba?
我非常看好星宿。
This is Session Clear Club, yep. So for the record, for those that don't know, Decession is a game that's kind of like an L game, which is a lot of very precise jumps. And it's currently rated about a 93 difficulty, I believe, on Delfruit. And so both players in the next race has cleared it. Yeah, it's a level on the harder side. Definitely harder than this tournament's going to. Ooh, mechanical rhythms in there. Looking forward to that one.
Alright, let's see.
Drum roll.
The sun spike.
It's a curse.
That is not a new
oh
game.
Oh my god! That is...
That's not a needle game.
It is, isn't it?
I wonder,
very much isn't.
I like that God has abandoned us, Tag.
Wait, which tag?
God has abandoned us.
Oh my god, there's so many tags on this. This is not appropriate here. This
is...
There's
no
way. This can't be getting in, right? There's no way.
Are they actually?
I think they might be. Why is he not changing this? Everyone in the Bilibili chat is just like, question marks.
Ghost, no.
Ghost, no! Kozo runs this. He knows it's not pure needle.
Ghost, no.
Oh no! Oh no! Do you want to message him quickly on this?
I'll send him a message.
Hopefully he sees it. Yeah, a lot of people are saying, roll, this is It's not... Okay, alright, good, we're safe, it's fine.
That would have been really funny.
Yeah, you can't even choose which stage comes next when you play. It's a random stage order, so you wouldn't even be able to compare who's doing better.
Ah, Lizdex Amphetamine.
Ah, yes, Yes.
Of course.
I feel like I actually know this
one
name.
One or two kind of bruh saves.
Okay. Interesting. Yeah, I recognize his name and I don't know why.
I
on the plus side,
it
is needle. It is a needle game, however, so that's got a big leg up for the previous one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm fairly certain this is very much needle as well. Like, that's a very needle title screen right there.
What is that that chat program they use? Any idea?
I have no clue, sorry. You'll have to ask them.
Sick. And here I thought you were Chinese.
Nah, I'm afraid not. Still working on Maybe you could ask Bomber. Apparently he's Chinese. So yeah, welcome to the one Western player in this tournament. We'll see how he performs. Or if will he be talking for this, I wonder? Because he's still in the Summer Feast chat.
You know? Guess we'll find out, won't we?
Yeah, I guess we will, because I don't know, Wolf. I actually can't answer that question.
Bummer and races? Generally,
races? Oh, I mean, races. I thought that was the name of the other guy.
No. The other guy is Saito.
Okay.
Yeah, Bummer with races tends to get pretty animated.
Very vocal, yes.
Yeah, so we'll see.
We'll see if Ghost turns the volume down in time. And Bummer looks at the screen and is like, why is he three screens ahead? What is this?
Maybe he'll opt to be intensely focused and say nothing. Minus the occasional Chinese.
Bummer's gonna speak Chinese, that'd be interesting. I think somebody actually asked during his morning dew run if he knew any Chinese. To which the answer was, not really.
没有开麦不会正常的事情吗？有什么好骂的？你自己不也是经常不开麦的，对吧？ 还有两三个小时说完不开麦的， 有人骂你吗？对吧？
Yeah, maybe he's connected to the wrong server.
Or maybe he is just smearing the good name of the Western community.
Don't worry, I got a classic run later that will put everything back to normal. Or make it infinitely worse, I'm not sure yet.
Well, they're both on the same save.
Yeah, seems like the first screen wasn't too difficult. This one's got at least one 16 pixel more, so it's a tad harder. Giving
having 16 pixel means it's instantly impossible.
Interesting. What do you do for this jump then? I guess you jump through to the left? I can't really tell because Bummer's screen is a mess. Oh, Bummer beat it. Okay, cool.
My assumption is he platform jumps up to the right.
Yeah, that seems like another option. I feel like you're supposed to jump through to the left and then you can jump up.
It seems very, freeform needle.
Yeah, it's interesting, for sure. Oh, and Saito's got a chance doing the strat that I mentioned. Just gonna walk off and go. Yep, there. Ooh!
Unfortunate.
Death to the last spike. It's always a bad time.
So Bummer already pulling way ahead. Not that you can see it, but.
Nope. For all we know, Bummer could actually be on the fourth screen and not just the third.
For all we know, Bummer could be splicing.
Oh, the song?
Banger.
Oh, are they playing the online tool?
Ah, 用的还是 PO 版本.
No. I think Saito playing in the online tool by himself because he just spoke on stream and said Laggy.
Oh.
这边细说还是用的PO版本.
This might be the first time I could actually hear the words in the song.
Yeah, I'm offended because it's not the Miku version.
I'm not even sure what the song is. I just know I know it.
You probably know it from Catastrophe Miku.
Okay, it's Catastrophe. Yeah, there you go. No worries, we're just gonna blame Bummer for the lag anyway.
Onegai kisu de.
I don't realize we have three nationalities in this race. All from one person.
Yeah, no worries, Ghost. It is not your fault.
Internet problems are always a pain. Praise code.
Having a multinational marathon.
Yeah. Yeah, Bubba was just removing spikes as we speak.
I was actually thinking for the Twitch side, it might even be better to just have them stream on their Twitch channels and we capture from there, but I don't know.
Yeah, that's definitely possible. Because then it's just your connection to Twitch as opposed to their connection to you.
Uh-huh. You can, actually that's probably a good idea, you can have Bummer set up his stream on Twitch for, I was going to say if he gets past this round, but it seems like it's likely that he will.
He's been doing pretty well so far, yeah. And he's passed the later race as well, I'm fairly certain. Yeah, like Jimmy and Fangame Marathon. Coming to the Hong Kong one. Ah, okay, gotcha.
This is too low, right? I feel a bit explosive. My head is very big. Thank you.
Ooh, death to the last jump again.
找了一个。
He is really having some trouble.
Yeah.
凑我一下的节点。
Saito definitely got some points. He's struggling. As... There you go.
现在是 QE 二三，现在是谁领先？冯冯还是？
Meanwhile, Bomber just doing Bomber things and liking the stream out. Is he winning? Nobody's quite sure. Considering he has a different gimmick, though, it's probably likely. Or it could just be the bitrate dying. I'm not actually sure at this point.
Nah, it could just be completely standard needle.
这个游戏有花瓶，还有那种移动背景。
Oh, Bummer is in the void.
Yeah, Bummer has left the video game. He has re-entered Morning Dew.
Oh, now he's back in the void.
I think there's an effect going on screen that was on that last screen as well, and it's just blurring the bitrate to hell and back.
下午连是没问题。
Or stage 2 could just be the void stage.
You are correct. That is a possibility.
这种问题在12点之后就修复了。这个是属于没办法的事情。大家谅解一下，大家谅解一下。毕竟不是在国内嘛，毕竟是。我自己要连出去也慢的。就我平时晚上看
球是非常。Possibly explaining the situation.
Okay.Hey, one side's showing it up. We can see it perfectly fine on one side, and then Bummer's cheating on the other one.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, that's the only way Western people can beat Eastern people after all, so.
That is true. Still up in the air about how your race with Blue went.
右边连的是在香港的那个风气，然后本身国外的人推香港服其实不会卡的。
Some random person just joined the odd line. Oh no.
Oh no. Well, hopefully he turned on race mode.
搞了十分钟，我不好意思啊，非常抱歉。
There's just like a random viewer that comes in and like blasts through the game.
Blue has joined the battle.
Yeah, I guess this person wins the race. Never mind.
Started about 10 minutes late, they're still going to get ahead somehow.
我再尝试一下，我再尝试一下。看上去还是不太行。
Bummer is having some technical difficulties, dang.
你的线路，其实我还有一条线路，但是一样不行，因为
Well, Bummer escaped the void and instead is now in ether. He's hanging out in limbo.
Yeah, I feel like Bomber's just about to finish Minecraft. He's in the end now. Ender Dragon's gonna pop up at any moment. That's just how far ahead he is right now. Bomber's so far ahead, he's basically in a different game. Not that we can tell, because we can't see any of this on his side for the life of us.
Currently, he's in a Bob Ross watercolor painting.
I think he's about to enter a stage 3, but I don't know.
It does look that way. Oh,
And now he's back on the screen he just beat, but he's walking along the ground because that makes sense.
Yep.
Oh, there goes the tile set. Oh, it's gone full mosaic.
Now he's in a washing machine. And now he's in the next stage. All right.
Thank you.
Bummer's going to drop his bitrate apparently. I hope it works.
He has gotten himself so far ahead with all the spike removal that he does have the opportunity here.
Kibana's a great song.
Yeah, Ghost has some killer songs in the soundtrack right now. So in case anyone can't tell, we are joking about Bummer. We don't believe he's cheating, but obviously nobody can really tell right now without this look. Oh my god, we can see the screen. It's a miracle.
Wow.
I don't know if I go that far. I don't know if I go that far.
What do you mean?
I don't know if it looks great. We can see it now. I'm not sure if looks great is the right answer.
I mean, I would say that the one on the right looks better than the one on the left, but also the one on the left has movement, so it's hard to compare.
Yeah, thankfully Needle doesn't need a very high bitrate to be able to look alright and be visible, so the only moving thing is generally the player. I think something's moving in the background on Bomber screen as well, but thankfully that doesn't matter enough.
Yeah.
He is sure showing up here.
I think it's just a weird, like, blur effect.
Yeah, Bomber's got out the first stage, and he has just been rushing this since.
Wait,
absolutely showing up and just getting through all this platforming ASAP.
Saito may have also cleared Decession, but he is looking pretty deceased in this race.
No!
Honestly?
I'm sorry, that was a really good comment on your part, Wars, but that death was really funny.
I wasn't sure where to go either. I mean, you just kind of have to choose one.
I just assume you do the jump, which is the diagonal, so... Yeah, no, he is looking, What was it he said? I interrupted before.
Deceased?
Yeah. They both played Decession, but... Yeah. Saito is very much looking deceased in this race, and I would fully agree with that.
There we go.
Bomber's definitely been showing counter-platform. I guess he could have gone over then, if he jumped high enough.
Seems like it.
Yeah, Bomber's very much been showing people how you need all in this race here. And I'm going to assume that's exactly what they just said on the Chinese side as well. Clear?
Wait,
Jesus!
Really? What the hell, Bubba?
Okay, cool, GG.
Wow.
Well, I think we have a winner on this.
Alright, I think Saito can still catch up.
Yeah, Ghost did say if both players are on the same save, it's whoever reaches the next save first that wins.
So if both people end up on the clear screen, it's whoever beats save one again first.
Okay, Mama, you won this round.
Yes.
Oh, Ghost just told me one.
Dang.
Oh.
Yeah.
So many good songs.
Yeah.
下面这两场都很有看头啊。
It's getting really scary.
Boa sounding like me in my blue race where I don't know where blue's at, so I just assume he's close. Generally a reasonably safe bet, but yeah, this guy's really been struggling with Sage 1 here. Meanwhile, Bomber making it look like there's no spikes on the screen and just forgetting how death works.
Yeah, he started off looking like a Bob Ross painting and then ended up just looking like a cheater.
Oh my god. I caught me so much, man. I caught me so off guard. Oh my god, dying. I'm so glad I got pushed to talk off. Yeah, thankfully Bomber 500's more than fine for this. So, Needle's okay at 500. Whew, that was a good one.
It was
speaking
that
game. Of... Speaking of cheating, who do you think's going to have the best chance in the next race, considering it's Jemmy?
Okay, so it's Jemmy versus Syrah. You
My
know?
Money's always on Jemmy. I always find it hard to pass up on him.
I'm going to reserve judgment before I see the game.
That's probably a safe bet, which is why I'm still going to say Jemmy. Because I've definitely seen Sarah be very good, but I don't know if I've seen him be Jemmy good. And what's the next one? Drum roll.
Do not know this game well.
I think he's a Chinese maker, so this is a Chinese game.
Silent Night. I don't know. Wilbur, of course, being a needle fella who has smashed records in I Wanna Maker.
Ah, yes, I do remember that name, you're right. Oh, that's Images of Bummer right there.
Pictures of Bummer, yeah.
I don't know what that chat tool is. It looks like Skype, but for China.
Chat. Yeah.
Don't try with that one.
No, I was going to, and then I was like, it's not gonna work.
For the record, by the way, trying to do a drum roll with one hand is really hard.
It was sounding like bongos.
Yeah, I can't do it fast enough. Interesting game though, because we got two Chinese players with a Chinese needle game. Definitely feeling like Jemmy is going to crush this.
Well, as an expert on this game that was just rolled, I will also choose Jemmy. Because boy, do I know this game. And, that's as far as my thought process goes.
Cool, thanks, Wall. Thank you for your input. Back to the studio.
Ghost is singing.
Minor problem with that theory, 128. Yeah, I was gonna say.
Alright, but I still think Q123 can take this.
Yeah, I think Luke's got this, you're right. It's okay, Luke's actually the second best guy in this tournament. It's just because he was against Jemmy and nervous. So nobody's going to tell because Jemmy's also going to win the tournament.
True.
I'm actually very much looking forward to this. I'm very much interested in seeing how good Syrah is in a situation like this. Because I do know very little about him as a player past. He has a Call Me It run and a couple of other minor things.
Yeah, I think he has a Sunspike as well.
He has a set? Oh, interesting. Okay.
Actually, I want to check. Pretty sure
I know I had to manually add his run myself for Call Me It.
So
he has an account. Wow, okay. That's decidedly alright.
Yeah, it's 9 minutes better than my PB.
Oh, 9! Okay, yeah, no, he's probably not going to chance then.
Right, bye, everyone. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, bye, Wasp. Apparently they're talking about GGM in the Billy Billy chat. I'm not entirely sure why.
Because this game is on the same difficulty level. Now they're talking about tassing.
I think a certain game that you may know very well recently. Sire is seeing your shiver record. That was true. Did we add that to the leaderboards?
Sure.
I'm double checking. all knows, we don't have a Morning Dew leaderboard, so Bummer, if you get on that, that'd be great. Okay, yeah, Syra. Wait, Ola has a time in Shiva? He's not on the leaderboard. Apparently, it's Gaffro and Syra. Never upload your run. Well, screw you. To heck with this, we're not adding a Morning Dew leaderboard after all, I guess.
God
damn it.
Yo, what is this version of this song?
Yeah, I've never heard this before. This is good.
A drum and bass version?
Oh, that's adorable, isn't it?
That is cute.
Wow, this guy has run two times.
Oh no, one person's cleared this at least twice already. Sorry, might actually have an advantage over Jemmy. I mean, I know this is called a dancehall, I just don't know what version.
Yeah. Definitely a drum and bass remix of World's End dancehall.
Actually, maybe this will make things, this race will be equal because one person's cleared it twice and Jemmy's cleared it not. We will see.
They both played the game. Oh no, is Jemmy a dirty file tour?
Did Jemmy clear it six times and loops around so much that there's no more save files? I guess we'll find out in a moment. Oh.
Well, immediately off the bat, I would say that this definitely looks like a Chinese needle game.
Yeah, I'm definitely thinking that Jemmy does not have experience with this game so far, considering some of the pauses he's taken to figure out what some of the platforming is. Syra already passed the first save, so proving his advantage here. Ooh, that's a tough landing. Syra basically taking no time to wait around on this. He knows what jumps are coming up here. Whereas Jemmy may need to pause for a moment just to think. Either way, this race is very, very close so far. Both players definitely staying neck and neck.
Syra destroying Jemmy. Absolutely right now. Not even a close race.
Syra does have at least two clears under his belt, and his the in-game time according to the second clear was 28 minutes, I believe. Unless I missed the hours there. So
no,
he's definitely looking.
Oh. What?
I don't know what you were saying.
I was saying you're correct.
Okay, it was 26 minutes, cool. So, yeah, he's...
Whoa, that is a weird jump. Bottom right. Oh, they're on the same save now.
Yep. Do not underestimate the Jemmy. Yeah, I'm fairly certain this is Jemmy's first attempt this as well, because this is a studio game from what I could tell from the title screen. Which means nobody bothers deleting their saves from a studio game. That requires some effort, so I'm fairly certain Jemmy's just keeping up on pace with somebody that's beaten this twice already.
近大家开始起飞了，都飞起来，飞起来。歌迷别卡。
Because that's how Jimmy handicaps himself to lose. And so far, yeah, he's definitely keeping it very close quarters here.Like, Syro is currently a screen ahead, but it doesn't take too long for Jimmy to beat another save and catch up at all. Especially when the makers put at least three saves on the screen, that gives lots of opportunities. So in case anyone was unaware that Jimmy was terrifying, here's some proof for you. Jimmy was a screen behind, and now they're both on the same save again. Oh, there's a skip! Oh, there's no way Jimmy knows about that. Oh, that's game-breaking.
Did they just jump straight to the warp from...
Yeah, Syro just jumped straight to the warp. Syro was trying to do the screen regularly at first, and then maybe he noticed it while playing here. But Jimmy definitely doesn't know about it. Oh, never mind. I guess he just got told about it, considering he just reached the save. Yeah, there you go. I guess Jimmy's doing as well. I guess somebody told him. Well, there goes Syro's big advantage.
Perhaps Syro said that it was unfair that he knew the skip.
Maybe. Being sportsmanlike in this. Well, I guess we're off to stage two. This is probably the second maker, because there were three in this game. Going for a very different graphic style here, that's for sure. If they're both on the same save, yeah, sorry, you go for it.
It has a sudden death, essentially. Whoever reaches the next save first is the winner.
Yep.
不是，这 BGM 啊，这 BGM， 这 BGM 很应景啊，很应景。
Is this coffin dance?
Yes, yes, it is.
Nice. Good stuff.
歌迷不用急啊，
我们两个进度真差不多，不
用急。It's a good song, so I don't blame him.
Yeah, I was thinking this might be Wilbur's needle.
From all your experience, and I want to make her, of course, you would know this stuff.
I've definitely played a lot of it, and not just saying that because I've watched it.
这谁我们都看得出来
吗？Oh yeah, that's Evo's still a thing, huh?
Oh yeah, I guess it is.
Interesting. Well, the stage definitely seems to be going through a lot faster than stage one so far. Syro is clearing things very quickly, whereas Jimmy is just taking a quick break to figure out what he wants to do next. How far ahead does he want to pull by the end of this?
Which song does he want to listen to from the Beatles right now?
Oh, Syro, this can't be done.
So yeah, both players advancing through stage 2 very far so far. Depending on how hard stage 3 is, there is a chance they might actually be able to clear this in time. This is clearly a very short game, considering Syro did have a 26 minute clear. Yeah, Syro still got a bit of a one screen advantage, I believe, but...Again, with how short this stage is, it doesn't take too much for that to go down very quickly as Jimmy just blasts through this save, damn. Just Jimmy forgetting that death is a thing sometimes.
Alright.
He destroyed that screen, damn. Yeah, and back on the same screen, like I said, anything can go in this. This race is going to be a very, very close one.Syro struggled a little bit with the first save and it's given Jimmy a bit of time to catch up, but he does still have his lead. Did they say his name Gumi?
I just heard Jimmy.
Okay.
主要我觉得50到80级难度界定还是有点微妙的。
Yeah, no, it's insane how fast Jemmy can be on his first playthrough. So yeah, reminder, this is at least Cyrus's third playthrough of this game. Admittedly, we don't know how far apart these playthroughs are, it may have been a long time for him. But this is most likely Jemmy's first.
Well, to be fair, it can't be too long because the needle search criteria is only a year.
I guess that's true. Yeah, I guess that's true, actually. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, this game has to be within the last year, doesn't it?
Barely missing the warp. Now it's time for Jenny to first try it.
Oh, yeah, so yes. Okay, fair enough then. Yeah, he actually does. Dude.
Barely.
Jemmy is terrifying. Well, this stage definitely looks a bit harder than the previous one, though. But they are on exactly the same save now.
Oh. So this tile set was one that I got when I rolled the J-Tool skins.
Yeah, this looks like it's from, like, Crayons or something.
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, I know that because of that 1,000-floor game. It doesn't have 1,000 floors.
Wow, Syrah is killing it.
That was a good first attempt, but like, ooh, never mind. I was gonna say Jemmy's right behind, but unfortunate death there. Well, yeah, it's in K3 because it's in the bi-cray on screen.
Now on the same save again.
Yep, not a surprise.
Oh.
Jemmy has admittedly always been pretty much behind Sire by a little bit. But again, because of how close this is, it only takes one mistake for it all to be over. Like, there have definitely been a few saves that Sire has struggled on in this game. It just struggles on one for just slightly longer than normal.
Jemmy opting to skip the landing that Sire noticed.
Yeah, Sire just struggles a little bit more than normal. Jemmy will take that advantage.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Dying at the end of the save.
Yeah, Jemmy notices he was too low. There you go.
And so
nice.
Man, that last jump was scary. I would have gone for the... Oh, actually, I was going to say I would go for the cherry landing, but I just realized you physically can't, so never mind.
Oh, this is interesting. That seems hard. And neither player seems to be too sure on how to deal with this jump either.
Yeah, okay, they're both opting to go to the right when that's just decoration from what I can tell.
Yeah, definitely looks like it.
Oh, Jemmy dying at the end.
Ooh, unfortunate. Still, we have 4 minutes left in this. There is a lot of time. Both players have been making very quick progress through this game.
The stage looks really fun.
Yeah, this game in general seemed kind of cool.
Nice, Sarah first trying that jump. That looked like
Jemmy still stuck on the last save of the previous screen, too.
I guess stuck is a relative word.
Yeah. Taken more than 3 or 4 tries.
Oh, that last jump looks rough.
Nasty, yeah. Well, yet again, this is Jemmy's chance to try to catch up. And I was gonna say this is Cyrus' chance to get ahead, but then Jemmy's finally beat that save, so...
So one save behind, and this one did look pretty tough, despite Sarah blasting through it.
And to save Cyrus one at the moment looks pretty hard as well, because of that ending.
Jimmy showing me that I am very much incorrect about that save, apparently.
Yeah, I didn't think that one was too bad, personally.
More so the water grabs at the start is what I mean. Aw, dying at the end.
Sire's gone too high twice, but made it through the third night. Jemmy's gone too low once, so... See if he manages that a second time.
pretty consistently staying just a little bit ahead. Cyrus really holding on to this one.
It's a very close race the whole way through. Sure.
Oh, that hurts.
Yeah.
Hey.
I know this song. This isn't an avoidance I rolled like a few days ago that I beat.
Congrats.
Thanks. It was fun.
I don't recognize this song in the slightest. Sounds cool though.
Yeah, I recommend the avoidance personally. It's called like Mary.
Oh, Mary Baden.
Mary Baden, there you go.
这真的很难神作了，就是刚刚只是一个小失误。
Imagine knowing someone's streaker is better than the streaker themselves.
难道没有过了吗？
Ooh, there you go. Yeah, yet again. Both players are definitely cutting this close. Like, Sire is just slightly keeping his lead at every opportunity. Every time Sire gets stuck, like, Jemmy does manage to catch up, but then a moment later, Sire manages to pull ahead again.
Yeah, Jemmy did that save a lot faster, but ooh.
Ooh, that's not how you do that jump there.
No, it sure isn't. It even has him a line marker.
Two line markers.
That's interesting.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
One to hold the wall and the other one to tell you to bonk. That's quite a jump.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'd say it seems like it's pretty easy, it's just fancy looking, and I'm okay with that.
Personally, I'm against it.
Oh, I see. Well, that's okay, because both players will be past that save in a moment anyway. looking at the timer, there is not much of a chance left for Jemmy to catch up. He really has to beat this save before Sire does. Because remember, the rules are that if both players are on the same save, it's whoever beats the next save first that wins, but looks like Sire does manage to keep his lead until the very end. Oh, especially with that one. Oh, right to the end. GG.
Sire the god.
Damn.
Jemmy's just gonna beat it real quick.
He probably is, yes. That race was intense.
And do keep in mind, again, that was most likely Jemmy's first playthrough, so.
Yeah, and Cyrus at least fourth.
Fourth?
Yeah. Apparently, he had to press yes on the title screen to do the new save to override the previous save.
Oh.
二的难度，你们自己。
This looks like it's got some gross stuff in it.
单次评分这个，
wouldn't surprise me at all with the style.
清水的单次，清水的旗，哪样呢？
单次这个评
分。Been over 3 weeks, close enough. Whatever.
标准还是不一样。
Very, very recent.
完全没观赏性，无所谓的，就他们。
Ew.哎呦！
首先，这个游戏在选的标准里面吧，对吧？没有错吧？就算
bad jump, yeah, five looks very nasty.
就他。
I was admiring number 9.
I haven't gone that far yet. This is definitely some very very difficult needle if it is chosen.
够简单的吧？
承诺吧，那就承诺吧。Reload一下。
This is stuff that you see somebody clear, it's not too bad, but
looks like
going for another. Yeah, okay, that's fair.
This is okay,
right? Sky Needle. From Whisper. I believe Whisper is a terrible
drum
maker.
Oh, nice. I think this guy was in chat earlier.Yeah, I think this guy might have been in the chat earlier on Fangame Marathon.
Ooh.
That should be decent.
What? Needle
making up. There you go as well.
Oh, this is a Korean
author.
He's in the needle making competition.
Yeah. Whisper's definitely in the chat in Bilibili, that's for sure.
He's a Korean author.
Oh, yeah, he's putting some question marks.
Well, I'm sure he's very interested in seeing this happen. Oh, there's Meteor 2x3 as well. So, the game that was made for his birthday is also in this race.
And Bummer is in the Twitch chat. That's wild.
Whoa, wow, what? Damn, what a coincidence. Man, we've got a lot of people here today, huh?
马爷是在左边对吧？马爷是在左边。Quick
Bummer, do an entire playthrough right now just to practice.
Oh, I never tired of this song.
Yeah, it's a good one. What is the name of this song?
I always think Sayonara or Planet Wars, and I know it's not that.
Nah.
It's something to do with space. And I'm fairly certain Keithy made an avoidance for it. And it's definitely in there. MSS Planet. Oh, somebody else just said. Yeah, I just found it myself as well. MSS Planet. Yeah, I've watched the music video for this quite a few times as well. It's really good.
I don't even know the song has Gumi in it.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure where. Because it is mostly Miku from what I remember.
Oh, it sounds like they're taking off, like switching off lines or verses.
Okay.
This song 不应该放电。
Oh, we should update the, I'm gonna update the schedule link down below.
Yeah, I was wondering about that.
I meant to do that and then I forgot to. Now the schedule's updated.
Nice. I assume the game's taking a while for downloading for both of them, so still just waiting for them to set things up. Reminder, the estimate for this tournament is 2.5 hours, apparently.
Mm-hmm. And, going by the original announcement, it is supposed to end in approximately 17 minutes, but
yep.
I have a good feeling.
Right. Strangely enough,
probably slightly longer than that.
Who could have ever seen a tournament going over Restimus?
Yeah, it sounds unlikely. Ski needle.
Wow.
Sometimes while.
But it's needle in the mountains.
There's no He's Yeti clean. In this game chasing after you. I'm going to be disappointed.
Alright, bummer, but hear me out. You haven't cleared it, so... he doesn't know what to expect from you. So, like, you'll come in swinging and he'll be like, whoa, I didn't expect that from Bummer.
Just channel your inner Jemmy and do what he did in the previous race. And True. Only lose by a save.
I have a good feeling that that's not saying that he's cleared it twice. Wait, what the heck is going on?
Yeah, no, the camera fucked out. This has been happening for a couple of the streams, so...
Oh, okay. I thought there was, like some sort of, like, super crazy gimmick where it's, like, you're teleporting in two areas at once.
So,
that makes more sense.
Toma, are you ready?
Yeah, he has cleared twice. Maybe more. Godspeed to Bummer. As his first clear was 2 hours, Bummer's first clear will be...
Well, I mean, Bummer's already got a save there. I don't know if that's his save or not.
Why, the final thing? Oh yeah, so he does.
Both of them,
so,
yeah.
Yeah, that's... Huh,
five,
interesting.
1448 deaths in an hour does not sound correct for Bummer, though, in comparison to Faz's.
Yeah, maybe not. Oh, and Bomber's decided to break the stream again, I see.
He's, hanging out. Wow, this, visual effect? Kind of rough.
Eh, visual effect seems fine. I'm only slightly biased because of having Speedrun Classic all clicked.
That is far more distracting than this.
Exactly, yes. Yeah, best of luck to Bummer. Yeah. He may have a rough road ahead of him here.
Everyone get your Bummer copy pastas out. Bummer, he's our man. If he can't do it, Faz will. What bummer? What are you doing?
Brother! Dude!
He just had to do a quick flex ledge.
I'm a sensory.
He's just gotta show off for a moment, just show just how far ahead he is. Just has to truly let Faz know who the bigger man is in this race.
Comedy tournament? Will that be
oh god.
Two? So what's the deal with homeless people?
Of all the people to expect that from, Sunblock was not the one.
No, it sure was.
That's ending. Why it was so good. Oh my god, yeah, the comedy tournament next year is just going to be 8 rounds of Wolfsk against himself.
I will lose every time.
You will, yes. Unfortunately, your opponent will just be too strong of a match.
The winners will all be the viewers because they get to hear the jokes. Right? Right?
Sorry, I was trying to not listen for a moment.
Right?
I'm too busy laughing.
So I can't tell if this is a stage 2 because it has a different background or if he's just, Yes.
I was just gonna say if it's a one-off because of the boss personally, like, but we'll see. So I can't tell either. I would never say Faz is throwing. Bummer's just doing a really good job of the whole not dying thing. Faz is just showing off that sometimes games are hard. Because I want to say the save Bummer's on currently actually looks kind of tough, but apparently he's just going to forget how to die again in a moment. Meanwhile, Faz trying to clear out screen 3, I believe? Maybe screen 4? Also opting to not do the swag ledge like Bubba did, and then still not die. Yeah, I guess it's a stage 2 then, because the tile set, the background's very, very different here.
Yeah, it's, you can tell they put a lot of effort into these blocks and spikes for this stage.
Man, I genuinely just don't really know what to say. Like, nothing against Faz, but I did not expect Bummer to just be crushing this.
Bummer is often, under respected as a player.
I mean, is he though? Because like, I know he's really good, but even still,
don't sleep on Bummer.
I can't, he lives too far away.
Okay, well, in the future,
if he comes to visit the UK, I can try it out.
But don't.
But don't? Oh. Good point, Cosmo, yeah. But we did take the CN3 world record back within about 12 hours. Also partly why I'd love to see Bummer play Classic, because boy would I have competition suddenly.
Oh, no.
Hey man, oh, if he did more runs, he'd probably give me competition too.
So they are on the same screen now. Sorry, never mind.
Bummer did manage to die more than a few times on that second save there. Maybe when Fail met these done, Cosmo. Then he can show you what's really up.
I don't know, Icy. I'd say there are probably people who were fully expecting Faz to win. I was betting on Bummer, despite the him not having played it. I was fully betting on Bummer.
I honestly wasn't sure, but the fact that Faz has two clears already did make me think that Faz would have a better chance of being close.
野兽模式就没关过啊。Beast Mode.
And like Bomb was just showing that it doesn't matter how many times you've cleared a game, people still manage to beat it faster than you.
跑得挺快的。
Like, I'm just imagining a Bala versus Jemmy race now, and that would have been absolutely terrifying.
面加一打。
I mean, Cyra's still terrifying as well.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no, he still got Cyra.
可能没看见。
Which is hardly a free pass in itself, for sure.
强行走走走那个，可以。现在是两个 save 的差距。阿哲，法爷啊，别老死最后了！
哇，这个档开始下毒，把满下这个档。
你别奶了！
哦，
这个档开始下毒，然后秒了。
Yeah.
Man, I hate not having a save at the start of the screen. It's really get me every time.
阿哲，
这可见巴满这个实力非常的稳了。
Yeah, every so often I just think, wait a minute, there's no save, and then it's fine.
Oof.
Ooh, yeah, that's Duster at the end, though.
Yeah,
I've noticed Faz dying quite a bit at the end of saves as well, which is a bit of a problem. He's died at the end of the current save he's on at least once, unfortunately.
Stage 3, it looks like.
Ooh, and there goes another one for Faz.
So I'm gonna harbor a guess and say that this is maybe the final stage, seeing as this game is called Ski Needle.
I hate you, Wolves.
It's pretty unlook. It's not attractive. These visuals are very clashy.
I hate you so much sometimes.
I get that.
Yeah, I guess each stage is around 5 screens long, and this will be the last stage then.
Bummer for some reason opting not to just grab the bottom vine, which would be the easiest solution for that jump.
Yeah, if you can do a jump in another way, I mean, taking the vine is slightly slower after all, so costs at least 1 second.
You want to know the slowest thing, though?
No, not really.
Dying.
No, I didn't want to know, boss. Why would you tell me this?
I didn't say you wanted to know. But now you know, don't you?
Wow. First you say these comments to me, now you tell me info I don't want to know. What's next?
Murder?
Okay, cool. I'll look out for that.
Okay.
I'll probably still die anyway. I know you're an avoiding squad after all. I wouldn't be able to dodge you.
特别是在最后这种地方，大家注意一下，注意一下。
I don't know if I agree.
I mean, you are in the avoidance section, get wrecked, so it has to be true.
That is true.
不应该是结尾不要摆很毒的神作打吗？吓得我去紧张。
So yeah, with how things have been going so far, I'm assuming each screen takes about 5 minutes for Bummer, and about 5:30 for Faz. So unfortunately just a bit too much. That is a rough first jump, okay.
Honestly, this probably isn't even the last stage because, my god, that would be, if Faz's first clear was like an hour and 40 minutes or something.
Hour 50, yeah. Good point there. I mean, his second clear was a lot faster, it was about 26.
Unless he was actually sleeping when he did it.
Oh, it was just a very long time ago. Oh wait, no, I keep forgetting that,
That's the thing that's so weird is thinking about the fact that they have like multiple clears for a game that isn't even is like maybe a year old at most.
你们顺带问一下，你们看出来了这啥？这一面这是什么东西？这一面？
哦。
顺便问一下，
oh, interesting.
这个封面的三个人都是谁
？What is
that? That's pretty good.
What is this?
It's silly, but it's funny.
Yeah, it's both an alliance tutorial and a bunny hopping tutorial.
Oh, that's what alien means.
What do you mean, alien? This is a line.
This 面怎么也有 BS?
知道，
Okay, I guess that was a 4.5. I couldn't actually tell then. Oh no, two saves? However, will he manage?
Why did this suddenly get so much easier after the first, like, three?
Alright, well, GG. No needle screen done.
Roselia. Okay, I thought it might have been.
Really, Master's nice.
This free just deleted it. What a guy.
What's Roselia?
Bang Dream.
Yeah. The Idol Masters.
Yeah, Idol Master, yep.
I don't know. That wasn't even intentional. I straight up don't know the difference. Like, which is gonna be which.
I mean, it's just. That's why I said Bang Dream. That's the name of it.
Yeah, no, isn't that from Idol Master?
No. Okay. Bang Dream's from Bang Dream.
Okay, well. Okay. Wait, this thing's over, so.
Did it again.
GG! Oh, Bang Dream's his own one. Okay, I just straight up don't know that one then.
Bummer. Absolutely destroyed.
Yeah, he kind of crushed that pretty hard. What the heck?
And this time you didn't even have to splice past the first save.
Yeah, Bummer, you're a little far ahead, so...
Well, look on the bright side, Bummer. Now you get to go in Syra. At the session.
Hey, you got some experience with this one. Yeah, what's the equivalent of last TIS for Needle?
GGM.
Yeah, okay, so Tomo with GGM, that'll be the final boss.
Yep. Alright, it's time. Drum roll. Thank you, Nell.
I'd say that's a good drum roll, honestly.
Yeah, it rolled all the way onto the floor and then stayed there. Spring is coming.
Yeah, I'm off my table, I'm gonna pick it up for the next one.
Visually hideous, but very competently designed
game. I'm seeing responses in the Billy Billy chat about this game, so clearly there's something going on here.
Yeah, there's some laughter.
Is that the sign for laughter? I thought that was the sign for it sucks.
Well, it's grass.
Yeah, which is, I think that's the Japanese symbol for Fuso.
No, in Japanese that's laughing.
Oh. But it's pronounced Kuso.
It is not.
Oh, that's what Google translated it to.
Oh wait, hold on. Is that not?
Would you like to re-roll it?
Eh?
Yes.
Okay.
That's weird.
Oh, but we get a chance to re-roll!
Oh, you're going
to... But we can re-roll because it's too easy! That's so good! Oh my god!
What?
You have 120 results, and you got the same one twice!
They just really want Bummer to play it. Another Whisper game!
Jesus Christ! These rolls are nuts!
WSPR大勝利.
Well played! GG! What the hell? This is... Was that Syra clapping? I can't tell. Because what is going on here? Dude, somebody has rigged the rolls in this match, and I have no idea how they managed it.
Shot and interesting. What
the same game twice, two whisper games, a free pass for Vomit. What in the heck?
8面有点短.
What is happening here?
8面不够跑吗？够跑吗？ 2分钟一遍够跑吗？
Do we do another drum roll? Like, not even for another game, just because.
Shot. 8面. 你们出来说一下多久啊? 这个游戏跑的话多久啊? 15分钟跑得完吗?
Oh no, it's Kusa, not Kuso. That's
yeah, yeah, yeah,
应该是跑得完,
oh, okay. Kuso means shit.
Yeah, yeah, I know. Okay. But I saw, I don't know, I saw Japanese people posting a lot of something crap happening, so I thought it could have been that as well.
Nah, it's just laughter.
Oh, okay.
It's all Chinese games because Bummer has to not have the home field advantage.
Oh, okay, so it's Kusa for Japanese laughter because Paramara looks like blades of grass. Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, I realized that I was still on Team Viewer and I was like, I don't think I need to be.
Paramara, this game is too short. Would you like to reroll again?
Too short. Oh, okay. Alright, reroll.
So I roll 1, 2, 3. So we reroll.
Collection
again?
2.
So you change roll.
Reroll again.
Sire again, let's go.
You
bet. It's gonna be I wanna bet next, even though that doesn't qualify. Meaningless again. I swear to God.
Reach the exit 3.
Okay, this is actually different. Yeah.
Does that say?
Yeah, that's the original
one.
Yeah, yeah, he changed his name to that at some point.
Oh, interesting.
It's actually a decent game. Though.
I mean, he only makes good games.
As far as Dofu's concerned, considering the other download is taken down.
Oh.
I'm fairly certain he's Korean, isn't he, Gaffron?
Yeah, I didn't think Spider was Chinese. It definitely looks like Chinese Needle either way. And that screenshot.
Okay, they're actually going with this one, so we are not rolling a fifth game. He's Chinese! Huh, I actually never knew that.
So, this game.
Well, okay then.
Your short ear point one is Spider?
Yeah, that's... Oh. I'm fairly certain myself. Maybe I'm wrong.
You can filter Delfruit Roulette by when you just go to Delfruit and then you go to search. It'll like give you a whole bunch of things that you can specify. Sure.
Just not saying the full.
Basically,
just not saying the full name there, so I'm just saying Spiders, shorten it.
Mm hmm.
赛爷还是刚才那个一样。
That's why I call him Spider.
Yeah, I get it. Okay, they are actually different people. Well, crap, I never knew. I actually thought it was the same person. And he just improved a little. I guess that was wrong.
Shame on you for thinking someone would improve.
Yeah, my mistake.
I guess that does explain why the needle does look Chinese.
Yep. Just scrolling through his games quickly, and he has one that's okay, apparently.
Oh, hell yeah.
5.3. And Wolfie gave it a 1.9, and I remember him playing this and getting really stuck on one screen. Seems like it got updated since that point, though, so maybe it's fine.
Someone in Billy Billy chat said, bummer, show hands. They don't believe him.
I don't blame them. Oh, mate, you said that about Faz as well. You can't use that as an excuse every time. Like, if it's the first one, I blame being tired. If it's the second one, I stand no chance because he's played it before. If it's the third one, he's just really... No, you don't have an excuse, man. If he can't do it, he can re-roll.
And then if he wins, it's luck.
Yeah, if Bummer loses the first round, they'll just have to play another game to make sure whether it's legit or not until Bummer wins, and then cool, GG, I guess.
I don't know if I agree with that, Wolfie.
No, I'm pretty sure 1-2-3 wins.
Yeah,
Johnny,
I predicted it. And so it shall be. And don't forget about the final boss.
Lily.
Yep.
Ah.
And
maybe Insanity. He has to be the final boss, man. It's gonna be Insanity.
Oh,
final. A coin toss against Wolfie.
That's a freebie.
Hold on. We can just get the coin toss out of the way, honestly, so that we know who wins the true final round. So, Wolfie, heads or tails?
He's never been wrong before.
Yeah, I don't think he's ever lost these sort of matches.
Alright, Wolfie, I'll do it then. Okay.
Cosmo's in it! Oh no! The coin flip master.
Okay.
Make sure you don't blow out everyone's ears.
I'm doing it, Wolfie. I'm here for you.
Well, Wolfie, heads or tails?
It's gonna be the 1 in a million where it lands on the side.
Oh, it's spinning. No fucking way, it's heads.
Oh my god.
Wolfie wins, let's go!
I can't believe it.
The first in like 6 flips, Wolfie's actually got one right. It is about time. He beat Bulma, he wins the tournament. Wolfie wins the Indie tournament, that's how it works. He was the true final boss, it's over, so it's fine. We don't need to see this match now. Dude, this is a good song though, damn.
Okay, bye.
Okay, so, we have an important distinction here. Bummer has played this game at some point, and Syrah has not.
That's true.
So far, we have had two matches where people have played the game. One of them they only barely won, which was Syra, and one of them they lost dramatically, which was against Bummer. So, from this, we can learn that Bummer will probably lose this match. The evidence points to that conclusion. It's only logical.
I think the evidence points to them both losing.
Well, I guess we'll find out in the moment, won't we? Let's go.
They're gonna tie and we're gonna get a tiebreaker. S saves.
Ooh, interesting.
Okay, it's GG. Bummer's already died 4 times.
Yeah, he's already died too much. It's just from here.
It's over. Everyone, bye.
I mean, Syro did decide to wait for a little bit. I guess he was giving Bummer some time to catch up. Oh, and he blows the advantage. Oh dear, well, unfortunately for Bummer, Syro's desire to beat at least one save.
Oh, make that two. Oh, but it's only one ahead.
Yeah, well, I think that's too much, unfortunately. I don't know how he's going to manage from this point onwards.
Yeah, I mean, 45 seconds in, that's when you can call a race.
Yeah, especially when it's 15 minutes long. I mean, that's just, there's not enough time left at that point.
I've played Rocket League, and I've had plenty of teammates forfeit after 30 seconds, so it's clearly been determined.
Oh, multiplayer online games, man. Yeah, you are not wrong there. I don't know who made that cat sound. I'm just going to assume it was Bummer.
It sounded like one of those rubber chickens that like you squeeze and the air comes back in. It's like
maybe that's the music Bummer's playing to psych himself up. He's just playing the rubber chicken songs. At this point, I honestly wouldn't put anything past him to play in the background.
Yeah.
But Syra messing up a little bit at the end of the save. Having some trouble here.
Giving Bummer a chance to bring it home.
At least catch up on the same
save.
Having a repeat of the Syra versus Jemmy match right here. Syra managed to do very well on some saves, and then on one save he'll just mess it up a little bit and give his opponent a chance to catch back to where he is.
Bummer opting to do what no needle player in existence has ever done, and he is looking ahead before jumping.
I don't know what to say to that, dude.
Looking ahead.
I have no words still. I'm too busy laughing. Oh my god, I was doing well at commentary for a moment.
Syra is really pulling this one ahead.
Yeah, I'm doing very well at the moment.
And Bummer is staying on the same one spot for some reason.
Yeah, I don't know why he's decided to give Syra an advantage. Like, he's posing in the air as well, not even on the ground.
It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see how it plays out. Oh, he's into the void. Back, everyone. Praise code.
Bummer has decided to skip 3 saves. He is going to catch up with Syra any moment now.
Oh my god, Syra's an entire screen.
Which, as we have learned from previous matches, means absolutely nothing right now.
Well, what it does mean is if we're going to have a Jemmy versus Syra race again, then what this means is that Bummer is going to consistently stay one screen or one save behind every single time.
Yep. Just like the prediction said, if you've got a low save beforehand, you lose the match. That's how it works. Mathematically, Bummer's going to lose this. Yeah, there you go. Cyrus still on that screen. Bowman's about to catch up, unless he chokes the ending here. There you go.
Okay, now they're on the same screen again, but Syra...
For a total of 5 seconds before Syra pulls ahead.
Yeah, and that was good. Oh, screen two. Ooh, the mini spike hell. But like, an extra mini spike. Those look like... Are those just normal mini spikes? They look smaller than normal to me.
They look like regular mini spikes to me, yes.
Oh, it's the black outline that's making them seem smaller to me.
Yeah, this game's very much like 3x3 looping around nonsense, it seems. Or maybe it's 2x2, I don't really know. And you just gotta try to find the ending. Which is pretty cool, honestly. Seems like a cool game.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a sad death. Yeah, overall though, managing to keep it not too far apart, only a couple of screens. The Syra is managing to do quite well the one he's currently on.
Yeah, Bummer's struggling a tiny bit and Syra is just blasting through. Okay. They're now okay, I was going to say on the same
no,
screen.
No, they're not.
Screen,
the teleport gimmick. I remember this from
Summer Feast Needle Bliss.
Yeah, there
you go.
Thank you. 2019.
Yeah. Except you died when you would teleport into walls in that.
Yeah, I was gonna say. This seems more like a puzzle screen, but it's probably more to introduce a mechanic. Oh. Also, there's only one save. Interesting. Okay.
See, if Q123 got into this tournament, he would have won.
Yeah, see, it's not a reference, though, Cosmo. These things work very differently. The scenario ones walk your set distance, and these do not. These are like the opposite side of the block, which is how it works in the Summer Needle Bliss game. So you have to shoot from a very specific distance away from the block as well. No scenario walk to your set distance. That's why I kept throwing me off when I was first playing it. Because I kept thinking it would be the opposite side as well. There you go,
first
being done, but now the
gimmick's
gonna get serious.
Yeah. Things will get hard real fast. Whoa, that's so cool.
Yeah.
That's so cool! Bro!
I think you have a game to play now.
I love this.
Jesus. Yeah, that's I remember really this gimmick cool being interesting looking in the Summer Needle Bliss game, but I'm really liking the platforming here a lot more with this gimmick.
Clever. It's a summer feast needle 2019.
There you go, okay. Oh, that's a jump here. That's cool.
This is wild, bro.
This song is very appropriate for a final match of the needle tournaments as well. Oh, Bum just opting to skip the corner there, okay. Required fire frame. No, not required fire frame.
Nope. Well, Bummer, not terribly known for being good with gimmick needle, so he may struggle when he gets this stage.
He couldn't even finish that one, huh?
No. Once you started laughing, it was all over.
I mean, we have seen the things that Bummer makes. He does make just pure needle all the time. I've never seen him use a gimmick in his game, so... Man, this... Yeah, I have no words for this game. Dude, this is actually really cool looking. And once we got out of stage 1, things have ramped up very, very quickly.
Yeah.
Ooh, that drop at the end though for Syra, jeez. Well, Bowman's about to get a real hard dose of reality.
帮忙到那个 gimmick 面。
Oh wow, there are a lot of reach the exit games.
看帮忙对这个 gimmick 能不能快速熟悉。
No, there's a lot of them.
There are five.
Yeah.
Wow, that drop is so cool!
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't see that the first time, it's so good.
No, I was busy looking up the game on Delphi.
已经反超不知道多少面了。反超多少面。
I have to jump far away and then shoot back.
The kid's doing a dance! The kid has an idol dance!
Well, Boma seems to have gotten a grip on how this gimmick... Ooh, never mind. See, gotten a grip on how the gimmick works, but unfortunately, that happened at the end. He's definitely got a good idea of how it works, but whether he pulls it off for the rest of this... Ooh, unfortunate.
This is a bit difficult to say. Bummer... In this gimmick...
And the jump that Cyrus on doesn't seem to be too much easier either, honestly. He has to really jump far out before you shoot back to the block there.
The problem is, he seems to be trying to shoot the top block, but what he needs to do is drop down and shoot the bottom block.
Oh, I didn't even think of that. Yeah, you're right. Echo was the top one as well. Man, I don't know when else you can shoot the top block there.
Top block will be going back, presumably. Oh, maybe not.
I think Bomber just missed the save on the next screen.
Oh, no.
So, you know how you were complaining about a lack of saves there? A lack of saves at the start? Yeah, that might have been useful for a moment. Yeah, he didn't press S. That is a sad way to lose some time, that's for sure.
And Syrah is really struggling with this save, but also Bummer still has an entire screen to get through to catch up.
Yeah. And he's got to learn how this gimmick works with spikes now, whereas Syrah seemed to pick that up very quickly.
Yeah, pretty insane.
Although Syrah is exceptionally stuck on this save, so it's definitely giving Bummer a chance. Never mind. Time's up, Bummer. Time to get good quickly.
It's all over.
Oh, yeah, there goes the advantage.
Oh my god, this is so cool. Dude. The pathing, it makes you do the same thing again. Ah, it's so
good. Gimmick over, though. Only two screens. Amaze! Okay. Oh my god, this is like, Quo 300 mazes. The screen just looping around itself like this. So you can see the whole screen at the same time, but damn.
He just went to the same place again, I think. Yeah.
Yeah, Fire is really good for sure.
Syrah going to the same place again.
Yeah.
He's going backwards. Syrah is very much struggling with this maze.
Yeah, it's because there's no platforming. People can't handle the lack of platforming. Yeah, that's what
going
that's
to the same place again. Syrah, get a grip! And now going backwards again. Syrah!
Meanwhile, Boma's still trying to get a grip on the first save, so... Oh my god.
Oh, this is good.
Oh, Boma, you're so close there!
Syrah figuring out the correct way to go. Let's have a
hand. Did he know, or did he just get one part of it?
Well... One part is more than none. Right.
Okay, Sarah, you got this?
Well, okay. Okay, yeah.
There you go. Oh, it's more of this. I wonder if he did this game before Quo 300, because these are some interesting things going on here.
I am pretty sure that's not going to be the case. August 12th, 2019.
Oh, okay.
And Quo 300 is October
18th, 2018. Yeah. Oh, are there no saves? Oh, there's no saves for this maze. And it doesn't look like it's too hard on the platforming size of things, but... There is definitely some very long sections here in this stage Cyrus on right now.
Admittedly, he has built himself up quite a lead, and there is less than a minute left. So Bomber is going to have to just blast through everything to be able to keep up with this.
Not possible.
Yeah, Bomber is struggling a little bit with this gimmick, unfortunately. Even Deathless, this might be a bit too much to handle.
Well, he needs to finish this save, then do the next screen, then do the maze, yeah. And then he's on the same save, so...
Yeah, there's definitely no chance now with 15 seconds left on the clock.
Yeah, I like the kid floss animation. It's great.
That was a good race. But it's all over now.
It was decided from the get-go.
The math doesn't lie, man. Those are the saves of the ones that loses.
Yeah, you say that, but, remember that race with, Syra and Jemmy?
Yeah, and he nearly lost.
But he didn't.
But he nearly did.
So mathematically
it's okay.
Speaking...
It's okay. Wolfie won the coin flip anyway, so...
That's
GG.
True. Well, he only won it against Bummer, you said. So... Wolfie needs to do a coin flip against Syra.
That's the only one that matters. No, the other one doesn't matter, it's fine. As long as it's against Bomber, that's what matters here. I'm glad I got as far as I did.
Okay.
This game is good, but it's not that big, maybe.
The gimmick was really confusing.
Meanwhile, Syra just trying to show off and see if he can beat another save while Bomber's talking.
Maybe this stage is only one save. Flossing.
Yeah.
Oh my god, he's got a Miku cursor too! Bro.
You
need a break from avoidance, Wolf. Oh my god! That's ridiculous! He just dropped through the whole thing!
Anyway, thank you, Bomber, for attending.
Christ!
Wow, bro.
Hope to see you again in London.
Yeah, GG's the racers. They did a great job today.
Yep, see you next time. Thanks,
GG
me.
To ear point one.
Would be very fun.
Yeah,
we have some
that.
Good testers. It's so good. Okay, thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Bye.
I've learned I need to download all the Reach the Exit games.
Yeah, I marked them all. Oh my god, this padding's so confusing.
现在还有个问题就是我PO的游戏还没出
Wow.
This looks so difficult. They were all released in 2019.
还有一个画风。打完吧。
All the Reach the Exit games in 2019.
Wow.
Like the last three are like a month apart. One of each is like a month and another month.
Dude played Coco 300 and was like, wait. I'll make an entire series.
Wait, we can do more.
He will make Kokoko 400.
And then we will test play it. And tell him there's too many 16 pixels. Well, that was a good 3.5 hours, this 2.5 hour run. I mean, Oz, you're talking to two people that don't play R1 the Maker, so...
I don't even play fan games.
I have played a little... I have seen a little bit of the Reach the Exit series, but not much, just enough to download them a couple of times. So I'm going to find out which ones I already had.
Yeah, well, ours, Pat has his Popopo map. Just wanted to put that out there. Oh, there's no and. That's it for the statement. Bold of you to assume that I have anything more than that in my head. Oh! There goes the bracket. Oh no, Bummer's getting covered.
No,
no Bummer!
No, the loser gets removed from the stream.
It has a shift. Oh my god, bro.
A shift stage.
Oh my god! I love this stuff!
I gotta say.
No! Okay. You shifted to the wall. I thought it was just a...